Yale is a university. This map is from 1774, Yale. So the first thing I'm going to show you, because her and Damon Richardson lied and said Judah wasn't on the west coast of Africa. It wasn't named after them. So the first thing I'm going to show you is a map from 1774. This is Africa, performed by the senior Danville under the patronage of the Duke of Orleans, revised and improved by Mr. Bolden and E. Bowen. Emmanuel Bowen is the one who made the map that we see the most. I believe it's the 1747 map. We see that the most because it's part of his famous collection in which it shows Judah on the west coast of Africa, the Kingdom of Judah. And they say that that map has been debunked. But here Emmanuel Bowen works on another map that they claim. Remember, they will tell you that they've debunked a lot of the Israelite evidence. Yet they don't touch this map right here. 1774, another map Emmanuel Bowen worked on for the Duke of Orleans. We're going to look at this map bigger. Still, you see library.yale.edu. This map has been enlarged already because it's such a large file. It takes a few seconds to get bigger. So, Negrisha. Now, remember, she said we misinterpret this evidence. We make this evidence up, right? Now, I'm going to build a case. I'm going to slowly build this case up because I want you to see how thoroughly and how much information there is for her to sit there and lie and say this information outright does not exist. So right here, according to Idrisi, the land hereabout was peopled by Jews. According to Idrisi, the land hereabout was peopled by Jews. This is the west coast of Africa. You can see this right here. This is the area I'm looking in, right here where the yellow box is. This is the area, Lamlim, right here. Now we come down here and read this square right here. It says, all Negrisha from the head of the Sanaga is very little known, but the situation of this great region as described by Ptolemy, joined with the knowledge of Idrisi, the Nubian geographer, and Leo the African, agrees with several new discoveries, all uniting to verify their accounts. I therefore conclude that the Niger flows from west to east and has an affinity with the Sanaga or has no affinity with the Sanaga or any part thereof, but falls into the lakes that communicate with the River Nile. So now, he's talking about the Niger River. The Niger River is going to come up again, and that's why I read that. So now, this area right here is peopled by Jews. The Niger River is mentioned here. You see the Kingdom of Dahomey, whose prince subdued the states of Ardra and Whidda, W-I-D-A, pay attention to the spelling, about the year 1724. You see Ardra here, you see Whidda here, on the slave coast. Ardra, Whidda. Remember Whidda, W-I-D-A. So now, this map, all these links will be in the description to the maps and everything else. So now, right here, this is a French website, gallica.bnf.fr. This is a French website. This is from 1890, May 1st, 1890. So we go down to here. Let me make sure. All right, text. Now, I'm going to copy part of this text, right? Whidda, Fida, we're going to grab this right here. Now, their whole point was, we're going to come back to this. I'm going to pull her up again. Their whole point was that Whidda was not named after the tribe of Judah. So now what I'm going to do is a French to English translation. And I'm going to paste the text into here that I just copied. Now, according to Google Translate, you see me do this right here. Whidda, Fida, Whidda, Ouida, Judah, or Ajuda is a city old, frequented since the 16th century by Portuguese slavers. This word is split up, but it's supposed to be Portuguese. Portuguese slavers who gave it its name. Its inhabitants were said to be Judoques, and they were indeed considered to be a remnant of scattered tribes of Israel to the north. The Alala River, whose real name is Ephra, had become Euphrates for scholars. So now, it says they were indeed considered to be a remnant of scattered tribes of Israel. So now we are establishing that this land called Whidda or Whidda contained people who were said to be this one of the scattered tribes of Israel, right? This is in this French document right here on BNF or gallica.bnf.fr. This is from France. I'll give you guys the link. This is from Bulletin Society. I'm not going to try to pronounce all this geography. And again, this is from 1890. So now we still haven't tied it to us, though. We've just shown that, yes, there is a place in West Africa named after Judah. It is said that the Jew or tribe lived there. One of the tribes of Israel was there. So now let's see if we can find any consistency in this. So now the Jews of Spain and Portugal and the Inquisition. This is published in 1877 by Princeton Theological Seminary. So when you hear these urban apologists saying they debunked the Israelite sources, ask them to show you the video or documentation of them debunking this source from Princeton Theological Seminary. Ask them to show you the source or the video of them debunking the map from Yale. Ask them to show you these things because they keep making these claims. So anyway, the Jews of Spain and Portugal, we're on page 68 of 148. The link will be in the description for you to read yourself. You can see it's not a screenshot. This is the whole book. If I do this, the page will turn. All right. Thus was Spain deprived of her large Jewish population. The synagogues were purified and used as Christian churches. The vast sums of money which were owed to the Jews and the still larger amounts which they were forced to leave behind them found their way partly into the hands of their debtors or still more into those of the sovereign. The chief professors of medicine were sent out of the country to the terrible inconvenience of the population and trade and industry languished till they almost died out. Unfortunately, at the time of the expulsion, the plague was raging in Castile, and the fugitives brought with them the disease, propagating it wherever they went, and not unnaturally causing their advent to be viewed with loathing and horror. This circumstance induced King John to hasten their departure from Portugal, for which purpose ships were duly provided according to the agreement. But such was the temper of the captains and sailors that they subjected the Jews to the hardest possible conditions. They plundered them of their goods and valuables, even to their very clothes, and landed them naked and bare of everything on barren points of the African coast, leaving them to die of starvation or to be sold into slavery to the Moors. Nor was this all. The king wrested from their parents all children from between the ages of 3 and 10 of those Jewish immigrants who from poverty or otherwise had omitted to pay the capitation tax on entering, or who were forced to remain in Portugal, and had them transported to the newly discovered islands of St. Thomas, which is the same as São Tomé, which then swarmed with alligators and other beasts of prey, to be brought up as Christians. So he's telling you, excuse me, the Jews were deported out of Portugal because they didn't pay the tax, and they had their children stripped away and sent to this island where there were alligators and other beasts of prey. This is another source from Princeton Theological Seminary, published 1882, The Earth and Its Inhabitants. Right here, page 320 of 628, the link will be in the description. East of Great Popo begins the Dahomey territory, guarded by the important town of Glewe, known to Europeans by the various names of Fida, Hasida, Wida, or Wida, W-I-D-A. I told you to remember that because of the map. W-I-D-A, W-I-D-A, same place. It's important to establish this so the urban apologists can't wiggle their way out of anything. Same place. So let me get back. The old writers called it Judah. So now we know why the 1747 Emanuel Bowen map says Judah. Now we know why this one says Wida. It says, and its inhabitants were said to be Jews, while the neighboring river Alala, whose real name is Ephra, became the Euphrates. Didn't we just read that in the French source? That they were believed to be a tribe of Israel. So now we have two different sources here. Two different sources. Let me see here. All right. So now I was going to. So anyway, this was published 1882. Two different sources. The other one was published 1890. So this one predates that source by 8 years. 8 years. So we have two sources saying that these are definitely Judah. And it says, during the flourishing days of the slave trade, from 16 to 18,000 were annually transported from a Judah, as the Portuguese called this place, which at the time had a population of 35,000. The titular deity of Wida is the snake, and the famous fetish temple is served by priestesses called mothers or sisters of serpents, and recruited by the abduction of young girls on feast days. So Some of them will tell you that it couldn't have been Israel because they worshipped a snake. And I would encourage you to go look up Nehushtan in the Bible. It was the brass serpent that Moses made that they began to worship. So snake worship isn't outside of Israel's history. But understand here, the Portuguese were calling them this. Why were the Portuguese calling them this? Because the Portuguese were the ones deporting Jews to West Africa. So, of course, they called it Judah. So now we still haven't established anything specific as to whether they were black or European. So let's continue. This book right here, brown.edu. So when the urban apologists come and say they debunked our sources, make sure you get the receipts that they debunked this document from brown.edu. Portuguese exploration to the West and the formation of Brazil, 1450 to 1800. So I went ahead and went down to page 17, brown.edu. You want to go down to page 17. You want to go to point 14 right here. Now listen to what happened to these people, and you tell me if you believe that European children did this. Just tell me if you think this makes sense happening off the west coast of Africa, where we just read that there were alligators and other beasts of prey. It says, by the year 1470, the Portuguese had found the equatorial island of Sao Tome. That's the same as St. Thomas, in the Guinean Gulf off the African coast. The climate proved to be extremely unwholesome for Europeans. Extremely unwholesome for Europeans. And settlement was slow. The official chronicler of King João II, that's King John, Garcia de Resende, reports on one of the methods to populate this island that also throws some light on a tragic form of Jewish participation in the Portuguese Atlantic Empire. The king had allowed Jewish refugees from Spain, from where they had been expelled in 1492, notice the consistency, she said we misinterpret history, to remain in Portugal only in return for payment of an enormous ransom. In 1493, those who could not pay had their children taken away from them, baptized by force, and deported to Sao Tome in order to be raised as Christians and to help populate the island that the king had just leased to Alvaro de Camina at the annual rent of 100,000 reis. Mm-hmm. Nothing is known of their further fate, although later chroniclers attribute the thriving sugar production on the island to the talents of those deported children and their offspring. So now she wants you to believe that white people were stripped butt naked, thrown in West Africa with alligators, beast of prey, white children, and somehow survived to develop a thriving sugar economy. This is what the urban apologists want you to believe.